Hi, and welcome to Showcase App Data in Spotlight. My name is David Stites, and I'm an engineer on the Core Data team. In this session, I'm excited to show you how to add Spotlight indexing in your app using NS Core Data Core Spotlight Delegate. The agenda for this session is to learn about the NS Core Data Core Spotlight Delegate object and why you should use it, set up a simple implementation, learn how to customize that implementation, and lastly, validate the code by adding full text search. First, let's look at Core Data and Spotlight. People are going to create and store a lot of great and important content in your app. As their use of your app and the size of their dataset increases, they're going to want to be able to quickly find that data both inside the app using standard search methods and outside the app, for example, in Spotlight Search. Wouldn't it be great to have the data inside your app show up in Spotlight? Well, this is where Core Data can help you. The NS Core Data Core Spotlight Delegate object does all the heavy lifting and provides a set of APIs that quickly and efficiently indexes content provided by your app. You just have to turn it on. Once indexed, search results will also appear in the Spotlight Search user interface outside your app. The Spotlight Delegate automatically processes changes to your graph's manage objects and then updates the Spotlight index accordingly. In addition, it provides robust index management capabilities to interact with the private, on-device only index and allows you to tailor the index results to your liking. In fact, any content that is in your persistent store is eligible to be indexed. The reasons to use the Spotlight Delegate are threefold. Number one, the Spotlight Delegate maintains feature parity with core Spotlight APIs. Number two, it removes a lot of necessary implementation code. And three, it provides a great additional feature set that we'll be discussing later in this session. To illustrate my previous point, this is a very simple implementation using the core Spotlight APIs that only adds items to a search index and reduces it to this, two lines. Simple, easy to read and maintain. I mean, come on, who doesn't prefer less code? Let's take a look at how to get set up and running right away. The simple example will cover deciding what to index and creating the delegate. Throughout this session, I will be referring to an app called Tags that I wrote for myself, which is a simple photo tagging application. This sample app will incorporate many of the APIs I'm discussing today. Prior to adding Spotlight support, you can see that all the tag and photo data is trapped inside Tags, as there are no Spotlight search query results for Natural Bridges State Park. Let's change that. The first step in any implementation using the NS Core Data Core Spotlight Delegate is to decide what you're going to index in Spotlight. What gets indexed in Spotlight is completely up to you. In Tags, I've decided to index the user-specified name attribute on the entity photo and the name attribute on the entity tag. To prepare the model for indexing, I've opened the project's Core Data model in Xcode, selected each attribute I want to index, and have ticked the Index in Spotlight checkbox in the Attributes Inspector. Our work continues in the Core Data Model Editor, as it's required to set the Core Data Spotlight display name. The Core Data Spotlight display name is an NS expression. At indexing time, this expression is evaluated with each managed object that has properties indexed by Spotlight, and the result is saved. Later, when the Spotlight Search user interface is shown, these stored results are used as the quote display name for the search result. What is an NS expression? Well, an expression can be as simple as evaluating a key path, in this case, tag.name. This object has quite a few more tricks it can do besides evaluating key paths, however. In this example, it's doing some math for you. The expression can be even more complex, such as calculating the standard deviation of a set of numbers. In Tags, the Spotlight display name is set to user-specified name on the entity photo and name on the entity tag. Now that the model is prepared for indexing, let's create the Spotlight delegate. Beginning in iOS 15 and macOS Monterey, the initializer for store with model is now deprecated. The new way to initialize a Spotlight delegate is using for store with coordinator. By adopting the new designated initializer, it's no longer required to add an instance of the Spotlight delegate to the store options prior to adding the store to the coordinator. However, you must call start Spotlight indexing for the Spotlight delegate to start its work. I want to call out a couple requirements to using the NS Core Data Core Spotlight delegate. The store type of the store to be indexed must be SQLite and must have persistent history tracking enabled. And with that, you're done. That's it. You don't need to do anything else, and your data will be indexed in Spotlight. I just demonstrated how easy it is to add Spotlight indexing to my Tags app. Now that I've described the basics, let's customize that implementation a bit. The first way to customize the implementation is by defining a domain and index name. To start off, I'll define a class, Tag Spotlight Delegate, which is a subclass of NS Core Data Core Spotlight Delegate. Now, I'll override domain name and index name with an implementation. Overriding these selectors tells Spotlight where to store the index data and allows you to better identify it later, especially if you have multiple indices. If you do not override domain identifier, the default domain identifier is the store identifier. If you do not override index name, the default index name is nil. The next step in customizing the Spotlight delegate is defining an attribute set. In the setup portion of this session, the NS Core Data Core Spotlight delegate object defined the attribute set returned to Spotlight for us simply by ticking the checkbox Index in Spotlight. Now I'm going to demonstrate exactly how to specify the attributes that will be used for indexing. Specifying which attributes that should be indexed allows more explicit control over what's indexed and how it's searched for. To do that, use CS Searchable Item Attribute Set. An attribute set contains a number of predefined properties allowing you to specify the metadata to display about the specified managed object when it appears as a search result. The attributes you choose depend completely on your domain. You can use predefined properties available in CS Searchable Item Attribute Set, or you can define your own properties. The Tags app uses the predefined properties keywords, display name, and thumbnail data. It's important to note that you should only modify an attribute set on one thread at a time, as concurrent access to the properties in an attribute set has undefined behavior. Back in the Tag Spotlight Delegate class, let's see how this works by overriding attribute set for object. In the override implementation, begin by determining if the object is a phototype object. Next, initialize an attribute set with the content type.image. Then, set the properties identifier, display name, and thumbnail data on the attribute set using the appropriate attributes from the photo object. Now append tags from the photo object tag set to the keywords array on the attribute set. It's worth mentioning at this point that if your model indexes a relationship, attribute set for object must be overridden so that it defines what about that relationship in particular is indexed. Lastly, return the attribute set. Since the model is also indexing tag objects, the code needs to handle the case of a tag. For that, create an attribute set with the content type.text, set the display name to the name of the tag, and then return the attribute set. As a last step, remove the core data spotlight display name that was set in the model editor in a previous step. Let's go further and define an event loop for starting and stopping indexing. Earlier, when we set up the Spotlight delegate, start Spotlight indexing was called immediately after creating the Spotlight delegate. To give you precise control over when the NS Core Data Core Spotlight delegate is performing indexing work, Stop Spotlight indexing has also been added to the framework. Using these two selectors in concert gives you the ability to start and stop indexing work as necessary, say in the case where your app is performing intense CPU or disk activity operations. Now, let's add some support for being notified when index updates complete. When a change occurs to an entity or entities that is indexed in Spotlight, that index is updated asynchronously. In iOS 15 and macOS Monterey, the Core Data Framework has added index update notifications. To be informed when the index update is complete, subscribe to NS Core Data Core Spotlight Delegate .index did update notification, which is posted by the Spotlight Delegate. These notifications will be posted after processing a call to save on NS Manage Object Context or after the completion of batch operations. Let's see this in action. First, check to see if indexing is enabled. If it is, then register for the index did update notification. Then in the handler, inspect the notification, which will have a user info dictionary that contains two key value pairs, similar to a remote change notification. A NS string UUID of the store that for which the Spotlight delegate updated its index, and the persistent history token of the store for which the Spotlight delegate updated its index. You can use both of these keys to determine if the store you're interested in has been indexed up to the latest persistent history token. If indexing is not enabled, you can remove yourself as an observer from the notifications. Prior to this year, the only way to delete data indexed by your app was to either implement the core Spotlight APIs to remove the index entries or delete the entire client graph in Core Data. Crucially, new in iOS 15 and macOS Monterey, Core Data has given the developer a new way to manage the Spotlight index without deleting the client graph, which is a great win for user privacy. First, the code will stop indexing. Then, call delete Spotlight index. Lastly, handle any resulting error in the completion handler. Note that calling this method may return errors from lower layer dependencies, such as Core Data and Core Spotlight, and you should be prepared to handle those. Now that I've shown you how to customize an implementation of the Spotlight delegate, let's validate our setup by adding full text search to the Tags app using the Core Spotlight APIs. The results will be what was previously indexed. Start by defining an extension for the Photos View Controller that uses the UI Search Results Updating protocol and a function Update Search Results for Controller. The Tags user interface has a UI Search Controller. We'll get the user input from that search controller's search bar. If the user input is empty, fetch all the images from our data provider and then reload the collection view as there is no search query. Now let's handle a case where there is a search query. To start, sanitize the user input string by escaping it. Next, define a query string using the user's sanitized input string. Query strings operate on the values associated with a property in a CS searchable item attribute set object. In this case, the code will be operating on the keywords attribute that was set in a previous step. In the search query, the modifiers C, D, and W are being used. C is for case insensitive, D is for diacritic insensitive, and W is for a word-based search. Now, create a CS search query object by specifying the formatted query string that was just created and an array of attribute names that correspond to the properties defined by CS searchable item attribute set. This search query object manages the criteria to apply when searching app content that you've previously indexed using the Spotlight delegate APIs. Following that, set the found items handler. This handler will be called repetitively with items that match the search query previously defined. In the completion handler for the query, which will only be called once, check for an error, and potentially perform some error handling. Absent an error, dispatch a block onto the main queue to use our data provider to perform a fetch for the items Spotlight found and load them into the user interface. Lastly, and most importantly, don't forget to start the query. Now that the Tags app has a Spotlight delegate indexing its content, the data has been freed from within the app. When I go to Spotlight and I search for a tag I have previously added, it returns two results: the tag name itself and the specific photo that I tagged with the keyword Natural Bridges State Park. Wrapping up, we've learned about the NS Core Data Core Spotlight delegate and how it can help your users find their content inside your app and outside your app in Spotlight Search. Set up the Spotlight delegate quickly and easily to start indexing without a huge code burden, and customized our Spotlight delegate using some of the new APIs available to you in this release. I hope you found this information useful and that you'll consider adopting NS Core Data Core Spotlight delegate in your project to help users find their content. Have a great WWDC.